CrapCigar.com, episode number 18, Consuegra.
I hope this old train breaks down, then I could take a walk around, see what there is to see. Time is just a melody, with all the people in the street walking fast as the feet can take them. I just roll through town, and though my window's got a view, well, the frame I look through seems to have no concern for now. So for now, I need this old train to break down. Oh, please just let me please break.
What's up, shit smokers? This is Long Ashes at CrapCigar.com with another cigar review. Hopefully not a crappy cigar review, but that's what the site is, so, you know, take it or leave it. Today's cigar is the Consuegra, and some of you might have actually heard about this. I've done a little research online, and it's a slightly popular budget line cigar for the simple fact that it's a second cigar, so it's actually the seconds of some premium cigars. Apparently it actually comes out of the same factory as the guys who make the Punch, Hoyo de Monterrey, Excalibur, El Rey del Mundo, and even some of the other somewhat medium premium lines such as JR's Ultimate Cigars. But it's a cheap cigar. If you buy them by the bundle of 25, you can get them for $1.40 a stick. And not sure if you can hear me because of that plane, but I'm going to go ahead and just smell it here. Doesn't really have much of a smell at all. I smelled it a little bit earlier. It's got a little bit of a barnyard on the foot. That's about it. The overall construction looks alright. It's pretty lumpy. Definitely looks like there's some bulges there, and the whole thing with seconds is every seconds you get, it could be a different cigar from a different batch, and it could be a different reason why it became a second. You know, it could have a tight draw to it, it could have really bad construction, it could have been a different size than they had intended, so I mean, anything's possible. But for the most part, they probably taste pretty similar to their premium lines, which is a good thing. It's a long filler, which is good because I'm getting tired of smoking the short filler stuff, but it's a good change. It's 7.25 by 46 is the size. It's supposed to be medium to full body. This is the Maduro, which is apparently considered the full body line. And the origin is Honduras. This is called the Casa Grande number 18. There's a whole list of sizes on JR's site that it ranges from small to long to short to big ring gauges. So I'll list some of those in the middle of the review just to give you a little bit more information. But speaking of JR cigars, I don't think I've ever bought anything from JR Cigars. I don't know why, I've stayed away from them. I usually stick to CI or Famous Smoke, but I'll have to actually go there and check some stuff out for the site, because I know they do have a lot of budget line stuff, so it'd be the perfect place for you budget smokers out there to get something. I'm going to cut it out of here for now and clip this guy and light it up, smoke it for a little bit, see how it tastes, and then I'll come back and let you know what the flavor profile is so far. Be back in a second. Still smoking the Consuegra, and so far I'm pretty disappointed. I guess from reading what people have said online that most of the time they've gotten some pretty good sticks, that I probably have my hopes up that even though this is a second and it's a budget line cigar, it was actually going to be pretty good. But so far, I'm having all kinds of different problems with it. First, it's burning uneven. I don't know if you can see that. I could probably fix that a little bit, but also go ahead and take a look at the stick. It contracted a little bit. It definitely feels more like a dried out cigar, but it's not. Every one of my other cigars in my humidor are at the right humidity and feel just right, so I don't really know what's going on with that, but the band just slid right off. The draw is super tight. It's really hard to get any smoke out of it, and the smoke that I do get is not very thick. There's not a lot of flavor to it at all. I had a little bit of sweetness around my lips for a second, but for the most part I just get kind of like an ammonia type rubbery taste. So far not pleased at all. I mean, if you look at the stick itself, you could see there's bumps and stuff in there, so it's probably plugged in several different places, and that might be the reason why this one became a second. The ash, it looks okay. It's a white ash. Doesn't look the strongest though. I could probably just tap that right off, and it's not too bad. But oh my gosh, look at that! I just ashed it. It's doing the cone. It's got a cone effect going on. So this thing is definitely rolled weird. There's got some issues there. But I'm gonna keep smoking this. Try to repair the problems there on the end. And hopefully towards the center of the cigar, this will loosen up a little bit and start producing some flavor for me, but we'll find out. I'm gonna keep smoking it, and I'll be back in a second. Hey, I'm back. I'm smoking the Consuegra cigar. It's a second of Punch, Hoyo de Monterrey, Excalibur, several other premium blends. You can pick them up on JR Cigars for $1.40 a stick when you buy them by a bundle. 25, and so far it's actually had several burn issues. It's been plugged in several different locations, and it really did a really weird ass burn. Just started to burn all the way down the end there, a very skinny burn that I had to fix. Just clip off a little bit of the cigar just to even get it going again. It's pretty disappointing. From some of the other reviews online, it seems like this is definitely an inconsistent stick, and because it's a second, you have to pretty much assume that. So if you're going to go in and get a bundle of these, you're going to have to automatically assume that there's going to be a couple that might be kind of bad. As far as the taste, it's not too bad. There's really not much to it. It's got that standard like Honduras, like earthy type taste with a little bit of sweetness. There's not much on the flavor profile. It's not a complex cigar at all. That may be attributed to the plug and draw issues. That could possibly affect the flavor, though I've never really thought about it that way, but I guess it's possible. Just so far, smoking it, I'm in the center of the cigar, and it's taken me about 45 minutes. So 45 minutes just to get to the middle of the cigar, so it's pretty bad. And it's not really attributed to a very slow burn, which is normally good on a cigar, in my opinion, but this is really just attributed to having to constantly fight with the construction issues that's going on with this stick. If I had to guess, this is probably a second of a Hoyo de Monterrey. I don't really smoke those too often, but I have smoked a few, and it has a similar flavor profile. Definitely a better experience when you buy the premium stick, but that's what I'm thinking here, because I've had Punch several times, and this does not taste like a Punch to me. I'm just going to go ahead and list off some of the different sizes. There's several different sizes you can get. You can get them in like a natural wrapper and a Maduro. I got the Maduro here, which is a full-bodied. The natural is supposed to be more of a medium-bodied flavor profile, so I'm smoking the Casa Grande number 18, which is what you see here. That's 7.25 by 46. There's also a Churchill number 15, which is a 6.25 by 45. Double Corona number 25, 6.75 by 48. I'm not going to go through all of them. There's several of them here, just to give you an example of the ranges of the sizes. There's a Governor number 16, which is kind of odd. It goes with 6.12 by 50. and jumps up to a President number 28, which is 8.5 by 52. So it's a very odd long range of different cigars. So you can definitely tell that they're coming from different cigar lines and different mistakes. So there could even be size mistakes in there too. So that's pretty much it. I'm just looking at some of the other ones, but I'm going to keep smoking this down and give you a little bit more information hopefully by the end, but it's probably going to be about the same. Hopefully the draw picks up on this. It's still a little tight, but the burn has gotten a lot better, so that's given me a little bit of hope that the draw might get a little bit better too. But I'm going to keep smoking this down, and when I get down to the nub, I'll come back and close it out. Hey, I'm back, and just finishing up the Consuegra, down to the nub now. Didn't really get any burn issues since the middle when I had to clip it and fix it up a little bit, so that was a good thing, but still kind of a tight draw, and it's just gotten a lot harsher. Really not a lot of taste offering there. Picked up a little bit of a woody type taste, and still has kind of a little bit of a sweetness to it, but not much. Overall, these are $1.40 a stick. This is like a 7x46. You get them in bundles of 20. You don't know exactly what you're getting. It could be a Hoyo de Monterrey. It could be an Excalibur. They could be a Punch. You know, there's a bunch of lines that come out of that same factory. So it's really hard to determine what you're going to get. And even in the same batch, though JR Cigar said this is rare, it could be two different types of cigars in the same batch. That's probably not going to happen, but it is possible. And they're seconds, so if you don't know what a second is, it's a premium line of cigars, and they have some kind of mistake on them. Either they were cut too short, too long, they're rolled wrong, so they have a plug in them, and the draw is tight. They don't burn right. There's just various other, cosmetic issues that could happen to the cigar, which makes it become a second. It's a good value if you want to take the chance of trying to get a premium line of cigars for a cheap price, but you're taking a risk there every time you buy a box of those, or a bundle, I should say. I would probably not buy these again. Actually, to be honest with you, if somebody gave me one, I'm not sure I'd want to smoke it again. I'd probably take it, but I don't know, if it's not a very pleasant smoke, and because of the burn issues and construction issues, I can't really say that it would be a good cigar for yard work. So it's not a very good yard cigar either. So this is just right along the smokable category, maybe even a little bit less. Like I said, this could be a bad stick out of the bunch, and there could be a lot better ones, but don't hold your breath, and that's pretty much it. So, Consuegra, seconds of premiums, $1.40 a stick, various sizes, natural Maduro wrappers, medium full-bodied, and you don't know what you're going to get. So this is Long Ashes of craftcigar.com, and we smoke the shit, so you don't have to.
Walk fast as the feet can take them, I just roll through town. And though my window's got a view, well, the frame I look through seems to have no concern for now. So for now.